வணக்கம். ஜீரோ சம் கேம். ஏ ஜீரோ சம் கேம் இஸ் எ சிட்டுவேஷன் வேர் லாஸஸ் இன்கர்ட் பை எ பிளேயர் இன் எ டிரான்சாக்ஷன் ரிசல்ட் இன் அன் ஈக்குவல் இன்க்ரீஸ் இன் கெயின்ஸ் ஆஃப் த ஒப்போசிங் பிளேயர். இன் சச் டிரான்சாக்ஷன்ஸ் The net effect of gains and losses combining both sides equals zero. Hence, such situation is named as zero-sum game. The zero-sum concept began with the idea that a win could only be attained through the loss of an opponent. A zero-sum game is one which no wealth is created or destroyed. So, in a two-player zero-sum game, whatever one player wins, the other loses. The idea was likely born out of an incorrect understanding of economics and finance, where the contested entity was considered fixed and unchangeable. Hence, a profit could only be booked by ensuring the loss of competition. But the modern economics broadens the scope, explaining that not all competitions fall into this category. It is possible for all involved contestants to register a win. For example, according to the classical theory of trade, that is Ricardian theory of trade, all parties involved in trade benefit from it. In stock market, investors' collective performance in the stock market relative to an index is zero-sum game. Since the value of an index includes all gains and losses. For example, when considering the outperforming the market, every outperformance implies an underperformance or loss elsewhere. However, the entire stock market system should not be thought of as a zero-sum game, because it does not meet the criteria to be a game with contestants. Only an individual's performance relative to the stock market index is a game. Poker and gambling are popular examples of zero-sum games, since the sum of the amounts won by some players equals the combined loss of the others. Games like chess and tennis, where there is one winner and one loser, are also zero-sum games. This is an interesting concept in finance. It has a typical meaning and typical application. We will meet in the next video with an interesting another concept.